Hello, my name is David, and I'm a principal engineer with Dell. Today I'm going to show you how to perform an authoritative sync of SYSVOL data using Distributed File System Replication, or DFSR. DFSR is the newer method of replicating SYSVOL. It's more robust than the old method, File Replication Service, or FRS, but it does still, from time to time, run into problems. When that happens, it may be necessary to force synchronization in order to get replication working again. In this video, we're going to talk about performing an authoritative sync, in which we designate one of the domain controllers as the authoritative source of SYSVOL data and configure the other domain controllers to replicate from it. We've got three domain controllers in our environment named DC1, DC2, and DC3. We can tell there's a problem by looking at the DFS replication event log. As we see here on DC1, it's showing several recent errors. The errors themselves are not that important, but we know that there is a problem because these errors are quite recent. If we look at the same event log on DC2, we see the same errors. And if we look at the log on DC3, we also see the same. So all three of our domain controllers have got problems with DFSR. And that's one of the main reasons why we have to do an authoritative sync. We don't have a working DC from which to copy SYSVOL data at the moment. DC1 is going to be our authoritative DC, and I'll show you why. If we look in Group Policy Management, we can see here that we have 13 GPOs. I've sorted them by modified dates. You can see that the three on top were created today. And if we look in the SYSVOL content folder, we can see that there are 13 folders here containing template files for those GPOs. And if we look in the same location on DC2, we only see 10. So the three most recently created ones have not been replicated to DC2. And if we look at the same location on DC3, we also only see 10. So DC1 has the most up-to-date copy of the SYSVOL data, and that's why it's going to be our authoritative source. Now to begin the authoritative sync, we will launch ADSEdit and connect to the default naming context. We're already connected here. Underneath here, we'll expand the domain, then expand domain controllers, and we'll start with DC1. Then expand DFSR local settings and select domain system volume. You see the SYSVOL subscription object here. We will edit it and scroll down to an attribute called msDFSR-Enabled. We'll set that to false. If you've seen the non-authoritative sync video, this should look a little familiar for now. And we do the same thing on DC2. Go to the same location, find the same attribute, set it to false. And then we'll also do the same thing on DC3. And now that we've got that set in the AD database on DC1, we'll use repadmin sync all / capital A, capital P, lowercase e, lowercase d to force replication from DC1 to the other DCs so that they will all receive that change. And that command has completed. Now we'll run DFSR diag poll AD to tell DFSR to check AD for configuration changes. And we'll do that on all three domain controllers. We could probably do this through remote PowerShell, but it's just as easy to do it this way. Okay, so we've run the command on all three DCs, and now we'll refresh the event viewer, and we see event 4114 and 2010, both informational events. These are indicating that DFS replication has detected that all replicated folders on volume C have been disabled or deleted. Basically, we've disabled DFSR replication of SYSVOL on all three of the DCs. And we look, DC2 shows the same events, and just check DC3, make sure they've got the same thing as well. So at the moment, we've got DFS replication of SYSVOL disabled on all three DCs. Now we need to begin re-enabling it. But on DC1, there's another attribute that we need to change as well. So we go back to etsy edit, go back to the same object here on DC1 that we edited before, change msdfsr enabled to true, but then we scroll down and go to msdfsr options and set that to 1. And we only want to set that to 1 on the DC that we're setting as authoritative. We don't want to set that to 1 on any other DC. And once we've made that change, we run DFSR diag pull AD again, and it succeeds. Now we refresh the event viewer again, and we see event ID 4602. The DFS replication service successfully initialized the SYSVOL replicated folder at the path. This member is the designated primary member for this replicated folder. That confirms that the authoritative initialization has completed on DC1. And it says to check for the presence of the SYSVOL share, run netshare from the command prompt. So that's what we'll do. And it does show SYSVOL and netlog on shares as expected. So now that we have done that on DC1, we need to essentially perform a non-authoritative sync on DC2 and DC3. So we set msdfsr enabled to true on DC2, and then do the same on DC3. Notice we're not touching the msdfsr options attribute, just the enabled attribute. So that's done. We do have to force replication at this point, since we made changes on the objects for DC2 and DC3. So once again, we use the repadmin sync all command, and that has completed. Now we need to go to DC2 and run DFSR diag pull AD again. And that succeeds. And then we'll do the same thing on DC3. So they've both refreshed their DFSR configuration from AD. If we go back into the DFS replication event log and refresh it, we'll see warning 4614 saying it's initialized SYSVOL at the SYSVOL path and is waiting to perform initial replication. If we wait just a few seconds, you can see that there are new events again. And if we refresh that now, we can see event 4604 saying that DFSR successfully initialized SYSVOL replicated folder at the path, and it has completed initial synchronization from its source. We run netshare, like it says, and you can see we do have SYSVOL and netlogon shares. And here in the SYSVOL content directory, we see we now have 13 folders containing template files. So we go back to DC3 and do the same thing. We refresh the event log, and we see event 4604 has already been logged here. It had enough time to complete initial replication or initial synchronization. So we run netshare here, and it also shows SYSVOL and netlogon shares. Then we check File Explorer and see that it also contains 13 folders containing template files. And we can see that the top three with the modified date of today have replicated just like they did on DC2. This confirms that the authoritative sync has completed on DC1, and effectively non-authoritative sync has completed on DC2 and DC3. Once again, my name is David. I'm a principal engineer with Dell, and thank you for watching.